In the criminal justice system, sexually based offenses are considered especially heinous. In New York City, the dedicated detectives who investigate these vicious felonies are members of an elite squad known as the Special Victims Unit. These are their stories.
Enough. I don't like it either, Monique, but yelling at me is not going to solve anything.
Me bumping in town? Just taking Maureen home from the beach. CG uniforms fighting this fire up by Black Bank Marsh. I stopped to help. Turns out to be a body. Gunshot wound to the head. Flames leaping off the crotch. I don't see the whole thing.
Sure.
I don't know. Kathy Victor residency all night.
Queens?
Dumb John. Looks like the victim was shot in his West Side apartment.
Do we have to get a court order?
Well, you can try.
God you have a picture of Senator Joseph McCarthy tattooed on your ass. Leave the dolly in the garage. Radio Velocity's redacted 1,200 pages of documents down to the occasional adverb. There's not a complete sentence in anything Craig Prince gave us.
It is national security, Jim.
We're looking for a murderer and the victim's missing kid, and Craig Prince has given us, here's your hat, what's your hurry? You think they'd want to help us catch Croft's killer instead of burying everything under the rubric of national security? It's too convenient. There's something else going on here. It's Munch. No. I want to see your spook ass now.
What do you want, Munch?
Anything I can get on a couple of missile geeks of Radio Velocity.
Oh,
Craig Prince.
No geek.
Shoot. What's his story?
We've been looking at Prince.
Why?
Kickbacks. Guy's living way beyond his paycheck. New co-op in Central Park West. New AA garage. He disperses classified money.
Ralph Noble.
Head of security.
Yeah.
Vietnam vet, Purple Heart, Silver Star, Medal of Honor.
Anything else?
He was hoping for an Oscar, but he's not in show business. There's a war hero, Munch.
Andrew Croft.
Guiding systems. This guy's the king of the missile geeks.
But I got nothing.
What's a black hole?
Who does that?
DOD.
NSA. Why?
We can fire a missile off a ship in the Gulf of Oman. 20 minutes and 600 miles later, it's entering the front door of a Hezbollah safe house in Al Bashra. It doesn't even touch the door frame. Anybody can load a bomb, Munch. But nobody delivers them like we do. Guidance systems, John.
What are we willing to pay for?
Anything. Erase your enemies, erase your past. Like I said, cross a black hole.
Why the interest? Croft's dead. Michael, his 16-year-old ward, is missing. Prince and Noble aren't talking.
How'd Croft buy it?
Bullet to the head, bunch to the crotch.
Ouch.
This new ADA really is. We need a search warrant for Radio Velocity. have it in Dave's office.
Uncle Bill.
Good. Look, I need a little favor.
You gotta be kidding me. You said we should try. You cannot just barge in here without proper notice.
Read the fine print. Step aside or have his officers restrain you.
Great, thank you. That was the state police located across Lexus upstate, Millbrook, right outside Poughkeepsie.
Cross transfer from Poughkeepsie.
Focus the surveillance until we get there.
Great, find something.
Nobody home. House belongs to Richard and Darlene Sandler. They own a hardware store over on Elm Street. Go underneath, 10 size.
Looks like we found the girlfriend from wherever.
Losing my job. Oh, I'm angry. And
until I caught him. And then there he is. He's a kid. He's a good kid. He tutors Down syndrome children. He's a straight-A student. He's a star athlete. He's Millbrook Township's favorite son. Now that gentleman is with cold-blooded murder.
How long have you been on the force?
14 years.
In all those years, how many murders have actually made sense?
None. But some I understood.
But this one, you let get under your skin. Why?
This one my daughter saw. I talked too much. Again, it was Jeffries.
Where'd you come in touch? Why are you improving your inner child with this improving of our own St. Cross against SCIC?
You printed the corpse?
So?
And?
Nothing. So? I mean nothing. Not obvious.
Zip. No parking tickets. No birth records.
Nothing to prove he even existed before 1991.
The year you went to work for Radial Velocity.
So we're going through the stuff with after the search warrant. We find this passport issued 10 years ago from San Diego. We call the local PD, ask them to run him. Bang, we get a hit.
But not to Andrew Croft.
Then who?
George Kaczynski, a convicted sexual predator.
Andrew Croft, a.k.a. George Kaczynski. Little George like little boys. Andrew Croft's been one busy guy.
11 arrests, 5 aliases, 4 convictions.
How'd you track him?
San Diego PD faxed us his rap sheet, found his priors back from there, department by department, conviction by conviction.
Only the feds can erase a file.
Radial Velocity is the feds. That's why they call it the military-industrial complex.
You're accusing the federal government of sanctioning the sexual abuse of a child. Please tell me you have a motive.
Where did you find these?
That's classified. There's only a handful of people that can calibrate the trajectory of a missile to within a hair's breadth of Saddam's mustache. Andrew Croft was one of them. Couldn't let a little thing like pedophilia undermine national security.
The child is wrong in the process.
It's not our concern.
Detective, there are many things that take a backseat to national security. However, if I had known Croft was a pedophile, I never would have heard.
Right. And there were no Nazis in NASA.
Mr. Noble will see you well.
Good talk, Lex. See you. I'm fine left in the old soldier. Don't you question my patriotism, mister.
It's Mr. Detective to you.
I'm going to tarnish up that Medal of Honor.
We can find our own way in. Thanks. Why are you provoking him?
The guy's a war hero. His life on life a principle. He's got to be gagging Stonewall and Cross pedophilia protect Radial Velocity.
Assuming he still has principles, war was a long time ago, John.
Principles die harder than people. I want to shot him was left to his. Wonder what he's doing for lunch.
My parents died in a car wreck when I was 8. The only other family I had was Nana. She was old and in a hospital. Andrew offered to take care of me.
Now, you're Belgian, and Andrew's American. How did you two hook up?
Andrew used to hang out at soccer practice.
Whose soccer practice?
Mine.
And this is when you were 8 years old?
Yeah. He and Dad worked at NATO in Brussels. Dad was a janitor. He was proud to have a rocket scientist as his friend. He said I was lucky to have such an important man take an interest in me.
How did he take an interest?
Andrew said I was a natural athlete.
Yeah, we saw your trophies.
He got me sailing lessons, tennis lessons. My dad couldn't afford them.
After your parents died, Andrew brought you to America?
First Bosnia, Israel, then Millbrook. I finally made some friends.
You even had a girlfriend.
Denise.
Bet you weren't too happy about leaving her.
I never felt like that about anybody. And not just her, her parents. They felt like a real family.
Michael, did you know that in 1990, Andrew was convicted of sexually assaulting an 11-year-old boy?
No.
When was the first time he assaulted you?
didn't. What are you talking about? Well, my experience, child molesters, they don't stop. You were a child. You didn't touch me, Michael. You're in a bad situation. You're safe now. You don't have to lie anymore.
I'm not lying,
Michael.
I'm not.
You didn't touch me. You didn't.
Hey, thanks for the heads up. I think I got the EED defense.
Not unless you climb through this stuff.
Are we working for the defense now?
You don't volunteer to do a hard time because you're embarrassed. This kid is hiding something.
Okay, maybe an accomplice.
Maybe somebody who smells a water engine.
The courage and integrity buckle to income. If I ever get in my face about money, if I cared about money, I wouldn't have been in the service. What do you care about? Protecting the reputation of a dead pedophile? Part of national security now? Right? Protecting Croft's reputation. What are you protecting? Croft's business guidance expertise was critical in Gulf War. Can you erase sodomy convictions for national security? Could any erase his convictions? Oh, is there another way to say it? Croft's felony record. Red flag him every time he crossed a border. A day is a lane with a lifetime in a war moving that fast. So radio velocity raised his past. We're depleting our arsenal with smartphones at more than $1 million a minute. At that price, the Pentagon wanted pinpoint precision. A complaint was filed to the State Department. A firewall was built around Croft so immigration wouldn't red flag. When the war ended, the wall should have come down. I can't tell you why it didn't, I just don't know. Meanwhile, a convicted child molester applies for guardianship of an 8-year-old. No red flags. I'm sorry.
Oh my God. 11 arrests, 4 convictions, more than we know about. 1 in Canada.
It's despicable. Get me Todd Earl at Justice.
Justice?
We need to secure the chain of evidence.
We didn't bring this to you so you could make a federal case out of it.
What about Michael?
What about him?
He's a child.
A child raised by a pedophile for 8 years. He was molested.
He denies it. There's no evidence here to contradict that denial.
Are you saying that he wasn't abused?
I'm certain he was. However, absent Michael's admission, you're asking me to soft pedal premeditated murder.
You're protecting your win-loss ratio, Elliot.
It's okay, Captain. Detective Stabler's judgment is clouded by the stress of the Morris Commission's review. And the fact that Michael did what he fantasizes about, kill a perpetrator.
It's not my fantasy, and I stand with Detective Stabler on this.
The kid had choices. He could have walked away, told a teacher, told a cop. Instead, he murdered. We let him skate on this. What kind of choice will he make the next time he faces an untenable situation? But either he corroborates the abuse, or I ask the grand jury for an indictment on murder, too.
No. Michael, please. No.
Michael. Andrew Croft abused at least 11 other children. He's a sexual predator. Michael, he can't hurt you now.
But you don't understand.
I can't.
You're a victim.
No, I'm dead. Shut up. I told you what happened. I'm staying in jail. I will. Please. Please. Leave me alone. It's murder, too. He's returning his own indictment. Sorry, Kevin.
Now.
So what happens now?
He's probably gonna go to prison.
our friends?
What if you don't have any friends?
Everybody's got friends.
Who do you talk to? Hey, you talk to Ryan Witherspoon.
More than you talk to Mom. Could the wound have been inflicted during a struggle for the gun?
Not likely.
Why not?
The size of the entry wound, the force at which it entered suggests close range, but there was no stippling.
Stippling is?
When lead leaves the muzzle, it's followed by the charge that fires at the gunpowder. At close range, it leaves a residue. Point blank, it embeds in the skin. That's stippling.
The size and force of the entry and the lack of stippling lead you to conclude?
The gun was 3 to 4 feet from the victim's head when it was fired. The victim's reach was only 32 inches. He couldn't have held the gun 3 feet from his skull, much less fired it into the back of his head.
The body was discovered wrapped in a sheet. It was blood-soaked from a head wound, and the genital region was on fire.
Where?
In the dunes, about 50 yards off Cross Bay Boulevard. A medical bracelet on the victim indicated he lived at West 83rd in Manhattan.
Blood splattered the headboard wall and lamp, I asked about. Did the blood pattern indicate anything to you? Yes, the victim had been shot while lying in bed. Any signs of a struggle? No. Forced entry? No. The victim's car was missing. State police located it in Millbrook, New York. The murder weapon was found locked in the trunk. Who had the keys? Michael Gorin. gun went off in the midst of a struggle?
Yes.
The police found no signs of a struggle. How do you explain that?
I don't know.
It's because there was no struggle, was there?
We struggled.
Over the gun?
Yes.
And it went off?
Yes.
In both your hands?
Yes.
The coroner found no trace of gunpowder on the deceased's hands.
I told you what happened.
Who is Danny Moran?
He's my friend.
Did you witness the deceased sexually assault Danny Burrell?
No.
Danny Burrell will testify that the deceased sexually assaulted him and that you witnessed it. Are you saying he's lying?
I...
Did Andrew Croft sexually assault Danny Burrell?
Yes.
And you too.
Since I was 8.
You shot him to stop him from molesting you.
No! I hated it. But I was used to it. I shot him because he was bringing over his friend.
What friend?
In Millbrook. This guy came with sometimes. Andrew made me do things with him. When we moved here, I thought it was over. Then I come home from school and he's there. We moved right across the street from him. Andrew was bad enough. Both of them are.
Who is this man?
He'll kill me.
He can't hurt you.
You don't know his powers.
Michael, you're in the custody of the city of New York. He can't get to you.
He can get to anybody. And he willed to protect his secret.
Child molester only has power as long as his secret is kept. You tell the truth, his power is gone. What's his name, Michael?
I heard them talk about it. Nobody did anything.
Talk about what? Who, Michael?
Andrew and... Craig Prince. Nobody did anything.
When did this happen? What boy?
I was 8. It was in the papers there. Nobody did anything. Great Prince can get away with anything. You can't protect me.
Right off in the third corner. Adjusted by the built.
Pray, goodness.
Excuse me, this is a classified briefing.
Yeah, Cross Ward, Michael. Grand jury voted man too. DA is willing to cut him a deal.
Well, I don't see what that has.
Even better news, you're under arrest for sexual abuse, sodomy, assault, and endangering the welfare of a child.
Oh, you're hurting me.
Not our concern. Craig Prince, you have the right to remain silent. If you give up that right, anything you do or say can and will be used against you.
Captain Craig?
This little boy's mother stuck his hands on a frying pan until his fingers burned off. This rape victim required 12 hours of surgery to have a steel plate put into her head after her attacker pummeled her with a claw hammer. This one didn't make it. His
there anybody on this panel who doesn't share Detective Stabler's anger for the perpetrators? This man is a good cop. As his commanding officer, I stand with him and every good cop who faces these horrors day after day and has the strength to keep their impulses in check. Now, if you can look at these pictures and not understand that, the problem here isn't Elliot Stabler. Is it?
Justice system, sexually based offenses are considered especially heinous. In New York City, the dedicated detectives who investigate these vicious felonies are members of an elite squad known as the Special Victims Unit. These are their stories.
911 emergency operator 307, what is your emergency?
I'm in the Lincoln Tunnel. My hair is less than 45 minutes.
You're reporting an accident, sir.
It's almost midnight. What the hell is up with the traffic?
911 emergency operator 307, what is your emergency?
There's a rape. Right now. 88 West Franklin. Get away from me!
Hello? 27 Charlie, respond to a 1034 assault in progress at 88 West Franklin. No suspect description, line disconnected. Respond, go 3. What do you got?
911 didn't get an apartment number, probably a cell phone call. We're not gonna lose. Throw my stuff in there.
If there is a penny.
Wouldn't be the first break.
You guys were special victims?
Yeah.
Found this under the fire escape.
Maury.
Got him. Repeat.
Special victims, Benson. Stable.
How you doing?
Nice and quiet. The door's unlocked. She's in the shower. I started to go in, but she started freaking out on me, so I backed off.
Okay.
finished. And then he brought me into the bathroom. He made me take a shower. My shirt got wet, heavy.
Did you see his face?
My shirt was over my eyes.
He told me not to look.
None of his victims could ID him.
Nothing for forensics.
There never is with Kendall Cleary.
When he heard the sirens, he pushed me back and I hit my head on the tiles.
Had sirens.
Did you call the police? No.
We got a witness. You move slow. We go after Cleary off this, or he'll be at the door again. The nephews. Well, move slow as fast as you can.
Dog and I.
tells you your husband's raping someone, then what?
I went back to sleep.
You didn't call the phone company.
I went back to sleep.
You didn't tell your husband.
We don't both have to be awake for a harassing phone call.
But he was here.
Yes. I called the phone company this morning.
Did they offer to put a trap on your line?
Yes, but my husband doesn't want that. They could listen to our personal conversations, and he's involved with private financial matters. This woman is ruining our lives. Why don't you stop her?
Check clear his phone records?
What would they notify the phone company after each harassing call? They'll track the payphone. She said she ignored the first call thinking it was a prank, right?
That's what she said.
Just went back a month, found a number in her case file. That first call came from one of Cleary's victims, Barbara Anderson. Looks like she's stalking him. Sorry, Olivia.
She'd be in his place.
Not mine.
Harper,
you can't stalk Cleary.
Stalking is illegal. I surveil from a legal distance.
Playing with semantics here can be very dangerous.
I saw him go into the alley. By the time I got to it, he was gone. And I saw the fire escape.
Did you see him on the fire escape?
No, but it's how he got into my place to rape me.
But you didn't see him go up, and you didn't see him rape anyone.
No.
And you called 911?
Well, first I circled the building to make sure that there was no way I could have missed him. Then I thought about the probability that he was raping someone. Then I called 911.
Why didn't you stick around?
Because he ran out the service entry right after the sirens. Considered waiting for you guys. I've been down that road. So I shadowed him.
Shadowed him?
Not to be confused with stalked.
And this is all not to be confused with obsession or drug.
It goes with the room. Have some wine.
We're working.
6 p.m. Workday's done. You can have a glass of wine.
No, thank you.
He's a workaholic. You won't leave the office till 8. We can chat for another hour and a half.
You couldn't identify him in the lineup. How do you know he's the man that raped you?
I was at his sentencing for possession of stolen property. When he left the court, he winked at me. Winked.
Ow.
Who did he rape this time?
Oh, he raped someone. Otherwise, you wouldn't be here.
Give me a scotch. Vodka?
No, thank you.
You don't have to be so tense. I don't expect anything from you.
We did everything that we could. You couldn't ID him, so we couldn't hold him.
You could have followed him. You knew he would rape again.
I'd like to follow every guy that I know that has a propensity to rape.
Poor police. So overworked.
Harper, you're not equipped to deal with this.
I'm equipped. I don't approach him. I'm doing what any private investigator would do, and I don't need a license to do it for myself.
You're harassing his wife.
Give me a break. She's enabling a rapist. And you're too busy to deal with him. So I will.
Harper Anderson is dangerous.
I'm not certain that she's dangerous.
Stalking Cleary.
He raped her. She's following him to catch him at it. We almost got him on the Lori Thatcher raid because of her.
You buy into her distinguishing between stalking and following?
System failed her. So she's operating it herself as best she can. I mean, Cleary doesn't know that she's there. She doesn't approach him. She doesn't threaten him.
Mrs. Cleary feels threatened.
Well, sooner or later, she's going to have to face the fact that her husband's a rapist.
Why? She's going to have to face it unless we prove it. And we don't want her pushed there by Harper Anderson. Street justice is always bloody.
Munch, Finn, bring Harper in here for a blunt talking to.
Captain.
No, you're too close to her. You and Elliot get in the Cleary's faces. Let him know we're on to him. It may not go to making a case, but I want to defuse this tinderbox before it blows.
Oh, Elliot. Look.
Stop it! Stop it!
teacher's rape?
She could do a voice ID, but Cleary ain't coming down here to see us on his own.
We need probable cause. Harper can place Cleary exiting Lori Thatcher's building. The building, not her apartment. After that stunt Harper pulled with Cleary's car, she zeroes a witness.
And there's still the problem of Harper stalking Cleary.
Harper's taking control of her own life.
Oh, please.
Look, as long as Cleary's out there, so's his next victim. We'll stay out there until we can make a case. We need to pick up where Harper left off.
I'm all for that. I can't authorize overtime to follow Cleary.
Anyone asking for it?
Are you with us? He's likely to call in lawyers.
If you don't interfere with his conducting his life, I've failed any motion he files.
Bingo. So you take care of that part of it. Now for me. What are you doing here?
I'm going to see a boss.
Got a problem with that?
No. Around the corner on the left.
We're investigating a serial rapist. What can you tell us about Kenneth Cleary?
What does he have to do with that? Is he a good employee? Is he involved in a rape? What's he like to work with? He's a workaholic. One of our top earners.
So he works late.
He's here when I arrive, and he's here when I leave.
We lost two assistants who couldn't keep up with him in Philadelphia. We're opening a branch there.
You go there a lot?
Spends half his time there. You think he raped someone?
He's a misdemeanor conviction for possession of stolen property.
You spend the night in Philly?
Yes. We have a corporate department.
Did we see his travel records?
I can tell the boss I was convicted on possession of stolen property.
What was your bail?
Trying to get me car, and I brought the company in $58 million last quarter. He'll live with a misdemeanor conviction.
I don't write this one.
Let me ask you something. One hungry man to another. Is there anything better than gorging on a fresh cut meal? I won't be eating that anymore.
Going back 6 months, three rapes in Philadelphia have Cleary's signature. June 13th.
He was there, the 10th to the 20th.
August 26th.
There, the 23rd through the 28th.
September 15th.
There. They got a hook on Amtrak to go there tomorrow.
Who booked? To go where?
Cleary to Philadelphia.
Well, then you're going too, John.
No matter what says. Why?
You found rapes that match Cleary's M.O.?
Three.
You're interviewing the victims face to face.
Something wrong with the facts?
Philadelphia's SBU is under review for dumping rapes as unfounded, so yeah, there's absolutely something wrong with the facts. I don't trust them.
She has any of these pieces?
Well, if she's an accessory, she'll deny it.
What are the odds? that she's an accessory to rape.
I agree, they're remote. The odds are that she's in denial, but wouldn't be, but it's still risky. What about the issue of spousal privilege?
I'm not going to ask her anything about her husband's rapes. I'm going to show her that.
Who is that?
If she's unwittingly in possession of stolen property, it might turn up the heat at home. You pressed them at work.
Then we've run out of place to make here.
So what, a Hail Mary?
She's going to be defensive.
I'm sensitive to that.
And you are?
I'm quasi-personal time. I called Harper last night because I felt like I dropped the ball with her, so I made a meeting for coffee.
Where?
Beside Rachel. I'll see you later.
Whoa, you're meeting her at a firing range?
I know. She's permanent.
Detectives Munch and Tutuola from New York City. They have a lead on the man who raped you. I know it's difficult, but if you can tell your story again.
I woke up choking on the pillow. He told me to keep my eyes closed. And then he took the pillow out of the case and held the pillowcase over my eyes.
He held my t-shirt over my eyes. He pulled my nightshirt over my face so I couldn't see him.
He asked, is this how you like it?
Is this how you like it? Is this how you like it? After he raped me, he made me shower. My hot water was broken.
He washed me.
He had me in a cold shower, washing his semen on me. I asked him if his mother knew what he was doing. He said his mother just wanted him to be happy. I want you to know that.
What made you change your mind?
My husband has always surprised me with his no special occasion gifts. A silver ring next to my coffee cup. He'd get so excited when I tried them on. I thought it was romantic.
Was it the faces match?
Yes. He gave them to me the same way. I don't want them.
Did your husband ever discuss with you how he came by the jewelry?
Don't answer that. It smells of religion.
Excuse me for a moment.
Do you want some privacy?
No. Just take a second. I can't take it. I can't take it. Come home. No. You have to come home now. We'll be on the next train from Philadelphia.
Yeah, I can't tolerate any more of this. You follow me to work, you follow me to Philadelphia, fine. You make my wife hysterical, and that, my friend, is gonna cost you. I'm gonna call my lawyer.
And the police commissioner.
You might want to speak with just your lawyer for now.
Hey, Cleary, you're under arrest. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. You have the right to an attorney. If you cannot afford an attorney, one will be. Raped me. I know how famous you are.
Yes,
good reason not to throw out the jewelry.
It doesn't fall under privilege. Nobody asked Cleary's wife where he got the jewelry.
Would anyone care for lemon?
Communication between a husband and wife is not limited to speech. Police went to the Cleary home with the express purpose of discovery. They should have handed the list to Mr. Cleary. He would have turned over the items. He gets his gifts from various sources, which he would have revealed. But in an effort to disrupt his family, the police went to his wife to induce her to violate spousal privilege. The court can't support that. The jewelry has to be excluded.
The police did not ask Mrs. Cleary any questions regarding her husband's activities. They presented her with the list of stolen items. She discovered she had several pieces of jewelry on that list, and she turned them in.
Please, Mrs. Cabot, don't you consider him giving her jewelry an activity?
Limit the scope to receipt of the jewelry agreement. The jewelry's next item.
Voice ID is a stretch under the best of circumstances, but a terrified victim hearing the breathless voice of an aroused perpetrator during the commission of a violent act? I don't think so.
You'll have your chance to undermine the identification during cross. Monty.
That's how I knew it was him. Thank you.
You identified the man who raped you, is that correct?
Yes. Kenneth Cleary.
But you didn't actually see him, did you?
No.
You identified him by voice, is that correct?
Yes. I'd know that voice anywhere.
Is this how you like it?
Do you recognize this voice, Miss Thatcher?
No.
Contemplate again.
Objection. Ask and answer.
Hearing the surprise of the witness, Your Honor, maybe she'd like to hear it again to make sure.
Go ahead.
Is this how you like it?
Do you recognize the voice? Does it sound vaguely familiar?
Objection. He's badgering. Sustained.
Yes, Your Honor. The man on the tape is a co-worker. You talk to him every day.
Robert.
You don't recognize his voice. How can you recognize...
Objection. Sustained. Back off, Mr. Schoenfeld.
How did you come into possession of this garnet necklace?
It was a gift from my husband. He gave it to me...
Wait for the next question. Your answers need to be very narrow and very specific.
Why are you only asking about how I came into possession of the jewelry?
I can't ask about anything else.
Why not?
Communication between husband and wife is inadmissible. It's as privileged as priest and supplicant.
You weren't going to ask me about how excited he got when I wore them? How he insisted I wear them before we had sex?
I can't. I wish I could, but I'm not allowed to ask about that. Do you understand?
The jewelry is important, Mrs. Cleary, because we need to connect the timeline to the rapes so that your husband won't be able to duck by claiming that he purchased swag from some guy on Canal Street.
He wants joint custody of our son,
and he's not gonna get it.
If he gets off...
One thing at a time, okay?
Okay.
How did you come into possession of this garnet necklace?
My husband gave it to me.
Was it a special occasion?
No.
Do you remember when he gave it to you?
Kenneth gave it to me on his return from a business trip to Philadelphia, September 6th.
Objection. The witness couldn't possibly remember the dates of every gift you received.
Mrs. Cleary, how is it that you recall this date?
It was our son's first day of kindergarten. Kenneth made sure he was home for that. He left the necklace on my pillow the night before.
Overruled.
Did you know this necklace belongs to a woman who was raped on September 5th in Philadelphia?
Objection. Relevance.
Sustained. You're on thin ice, Miss Cabot. Stick to the scope.
Mrs. Cleary, do you recognize
this ring?
I do.
Do you remember how you came into possession of it?
My husband gave it to me. dressing for a charity event. He asked me to try it on. And then he got so excited he had to have sex with me.
Objection.
You get so excited if I wouldn't have sex with him, he'd master me.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, you are excused.
I'm sorry.
Approach.
I'm sorry.
I hold you responsible, Miss Cabot. You know the limits set before you. You prepped your witness. You knew she was in a severe and emotional state, and you now have the pleasure of starting over. In the interim, I sincerely hope you acquire some professionalism.
Justice system, sexually based offenses are considered especially heinous. In New York City, the dedicated detectives who investigate these vicious felonies are members of an elite squad known as the Special Victims Unit. These are their stories.
That was just thrilling to pass. Too bad you could break it for a TV.
Hurry up, boys,
ambulance. Imagine if we still had Keyshawn.
Has anyone seen Emily?
I know, but we'd really be smoking with both guns out there.
Excuse me.
Hold on a second.
Emily?
How should I know?
Well, didn't anyone bother to wake her?
Not my responsibility.
Hurry up, Michael. We leave in 10 minutes.
pressure building for hours, maybe days.
Awesome.
And blunt trauma. I ran a skeletal and neural workup. Discovered a fractured left femur, healed approximately 6 weeks. Hairline fractures in the ribs, bruising the arms and pelvic region. Vaginal trauma indicated sexual abuse, so we did a rape kit.
Where is she now?
Neurosurgery.
Chances?
Too soon to tell.
Who brought her in?
Her mother.
Jamie McKenna.
She straightened up and she made a life for herself, and she wanted to share that life with Emily. her husband support her decision to sue for custody?
Completely. And he paid the price. The day after she filed, Denny broke 3 bones in his face and threatened to kill him.
What did Randall do?
Against my advice, he offered Denny a deal. He wouldn't file charges if Denny would agree to give up the child.
Did he agree?
He has until Friday to sign the papers. I actually hope the vile creature refuses, and he gets the full measure of what he deserves.
Our first contact with Emily was in April of 1994 when the hospital called us in. The baby was very sick, and since Jamie was struggling with her own addiction, custody was granted to the father.
Even though he had a record?
A prison record doesn't terminate parental rights.
How did Jamie's mother react to the arrangement?
Mrs. Huntington was the driving force behind it. In fact, she used her connections to push through the paperwork.
And when did Jamie start challenging that arrangement?
About a year ago. That's when the abuse charges surfaced. We investigated, but we couldn't find sufficient evidence to pursue a case.
Broken bones ain't sufficient enough.
Normal childhood mishaps.
And how would you characterize this latest mishap?
We followed procedure.
And that lets you sleep at night?
I haven't had a good night's sleep in 10 years.
Denny works 3 shifts in the kitchen and still finds time to join Emily's class for story time. He tells such wonderful stories about his childhood in Cuba.
Yeah, you filed an abuse report with ACS.
I'm required by law to report any injury, even those that can be attributed to simple stress or prepubescent clumsiness.
Which of the above caused a broken leg?
Emily said she fell when she was learning to ride a bicycle that her father bought her for her birthday.
You don't think she was abused?
I don't think her father was responsible.
Why not?
I have known Danny for 6 years, and in all that time, I've never even heard him raise his voice to her.
Is there any other adult who had regular or prolonged contact with her?
Henry Abedin. He's the minister for protocol for the Brunei mission. He's a friend of the school, and he's taken a special interest in Emily.
How special?
Well, he reads to her, he takes her to dance class and to the theater, but he loves the child, and she loves him.
No offense, Miss Dunlap, the kids don't always come straight with their teachers. Is there anyone else, a friend, classmate, who she was close to?
Well, there is a little girl named Jennifer. They are always together, they're like sisters.
Hi, Jennifer.
Hi.
I'm Detective Munch.
That's a funny name.
Anything else, man? I guess if I ever have kids, I have to call them Munchkins. Can we talk about your friend Emily?
It's not nice to talk behind people's backs.
That's true. But I think it would be okay just this one time. You know, Emily's hurt, and we're trying to help her. You want to help her too, don't you?
Yeah.
Good. Should I talk to you about her friend Henry?
He's nice. He takes her to show.
How about her daddy?
She said he was mad.
How come?
Her mommy was trying to take her away.
She say anything else about her daddy?
She said they were going on a trip.
Where?
It's a secret.
It's okay, we're her friends.
They said they were going to Cuba. That's an island.
Sure is, honey. Maybe later. So then I have to help Emily now. But thank you for talking to me.
You're welcome. Can I go now?
Sure.
do the right thing. We want to help you, but you gotta tell us the truth.
Guys, got a minute?
for a loving stepfather.
Him is like a jigsaw puzzle. Nobody gives you a whole picture.
Well, let's look at the pieces we've got. One suspect eliminated, one cooperating, and one hiding behind his lawyer.
Pictures getting clearer.
What's the status on the court order?
Cabot's meeting with Judge Petrovsky in the morning.
And the little girl?
Still in the car.
Well, let's all say a prayer this doesn't turn into a murder case.
As sad as it sounds,
she's probably safer in that hospital bed than she's ever been in her room.
Of an ongoing pattern of abuse. Blood analysis has excluded her father and Mr. Hominem from the suspect pool, leaving only Mr. McKenna with access and opportunity.
There is not a shred of solid evidence linking my client to the crime.
Mr. McKenna refuses to submit a sample for analysis.
They haven't established exclusive opportunity.
We can provide a detailed timeline of Emily's whereabouts during the 24 hours prior to her admission into the hospital. Mr. McKenna has a clear window of access.
Can your client account for his whereabouts during this window?
He was home, Your Honor, with his family.
Not to be redundant, but that's precisely our point.
A point well taken. I hereby order your client to present himself to the medical examiner by 10 a.m. tomorrow, Mr. Woodrow, or he will find himself in contempt.
Hey, Alex. We heard that Randall McKenna didn't bother to show up to his own hearing.
Why should he? His lawyer's already on his way up to the ruling.
You have grounds? No, but Woodrow's gonna blow some smoke to earn his retainer. End of the day, I'm sure we'll prevail.
Olivia, I want you to put a tag on Mr. McKenna. If he is 1 minute late to the Emmy, I want him arrested for contempt.
Yeah, thanks, John. There's no need for that tag. Randall McKenna is in critical condition at Mercy General.
What happened?
According to Munch, cerebral hemorrhage due to blunt force trauma. Somebody beat the hell out of him.
Come out to him. begged them not to do this. I mean, with my record, you know, I could be deported.
So, he listened?
He laughed. He said that Jamie's mother knew people at the State Department that I was already as good as gone.
And then what?
Next thing I know, I was on top of him, hitting him again and again. Till I realized that he wasn't moving anymore. I found the payphone. I called 911. I went home. And I changed my clothes. I wanted to see my daughter just one more time, you know? Before I turned myself in. So, what happens now?
It's hard to say. You did a real number on him, Denny.
No worse than what he did to my baby.
He should have let the system work for him. His experience with the system hasn't exactly been encouraging.
Hardly an excuse. I'm just saying, if it was your kid.
Okay, thanks. That was a laugh. We got a make on the nylon bristle, traced into a plant in Akron that manufactures hairbrushes.
So the hair sample of the rape kit came from a brush?
And it doesn't belong to Randall. DNA doesn't match.
Then he stopped the wrong guy.
He's in the right neighborhood. Preliminary analysis tags someone in Randall's bloodline.
I don't understand.
I know, I'm sorry, Jamie, but these detectives have a job to do.
But we're the victims here. My husband, my daughter, haven't we suffered enough?
Thank you.
check the x-rays and blood type for the medical records against Emily's, and they're one and the same.
We also found ashes in four separate clinics and hospitals. In each case, she's a different alias and paid in cash, so there'd be no paper trail.
She could have been covering for her husband.
Or Justin.
We've been assuming the attacker is male because of the sexual abuse, but suppose it was Jamie all along. It's possible his injuries aren't even sexual.
It's an interesting tactic. Abuse the kid, pin it on the ex, dad goes to jail, mom wins custody by default.
And if her daughter dies in the process?
Bonus.
Excuse me?
Kid is nothing more than a means to an end.
Which is?
Attention. Sympathy. Love. People who suffered abuse in childhood tend to repeat the pattern with their own children. This is an extreme case because of the rage, but in the end, she's just wrapping herself in the warm cloak of victimhood.
Yeah, but if she's looking for sympathy, why use the aliases to control the outcome?
Rape kit analysis would have excluded Denny from the get-go, leaving her without a scapegoat.
Tell Justin showed up.
Justin, we know this is a pain in the ass for you. Just meet us halfway. Maybe we can help you out.
Whatever.
You said that you didn't hurt your stepsister.
I didn't.
But your stepmother said that you were the only one that was alone with her that night.
Yeah, for about 2 minutes. And Jamie says she was gone for an hour. Maybe she was.
That's enough. Enough, Seth.
Very clearly, we are trying to get you out of here. You understand that? Now you keep talking in circles. You're going to be spending your varsity years behind bars. Look, I don't know how long she was gone. All I know is once she was out the door, I took off.
Where'd you go?
I was bored as hell, so I went for a run in the park.
Okay, where?
Down the ice rink over the baseball diamonds and back.
Anybody see you?
I'm sure they did, but I didn't take names.
How long were you gone?
I don't know, an hour?
Was your stepmother there when you got home?
She held me out for leaving that brat alone. I mean, the kid was asleep. What difference did it make?
If he's telling the truth, Jamie could have hurt the girl before he got home. Without proof, it's just more finger pointing. We need corroborating testimony.
Man, all the other witnesses are either mute or in a coma.
What about the druggist? Jamie said that she went to fill a prescription.
She didn't give a name, but if the kid's got a chronic condition, maybe she got on a camera in the neighborhood.
Well, that's a start, but we need someone closer to home.
The neighbors were not helpful.
What about that nosy doorman at Jack's when we served the search warrant?
He said that he didn't see anything out of the ordinary.
Maybe you didn't ask the right questions.
First the little girl, then her husband. My heart goes out to her.
Do you remember seeing Jamie hanging out with her four-year-old on Sunday night?
Come to think of it, kid was breathing heavy. He's got asthma, you know. I offered to flag a cab, but she said they were just going down the block.
How was the older boy?
Justin? That was got an attitude. Came storming out right after Jamie pulled the part.
Told him it ain't safe for a kid after dark, but would he listen?
You got a time?
Around 9. I was just about to take my break.
Do you know what time Jamie got back?
Didn't see her.
Well, she could have walked in while I was taking a powder.
Excuse me. Where's Finn?
We have to cover more ground.
Where's the drugstore?
Pharmacist checked Jamie's receipt. It was time code at 9:09 p.m. after closing. But she called mid-touchers think that he'd waited for her. He said she was in and out in 5 minutes.
How far along?
5 minutes, 10 minutes with a kid in tow.
That puts her back here at 9:20, 9:30.
What'd you learn from the doorman?
Couldn't place Jamie, but remembers Justin getting back after 10.
Serious damage.
You're circling the building, but unless you can place her in the apartment at the time of the assault, you don't have a case.
What about the hospital fraud?
Well, it's not fraud if she paid the bills.
Consciousness of guilt?
Even if you can prove Jamie was the one who took Emily to those facilities, you can't bootstrap aggravated child abuse to her conduct without a more definitive causal link.
You remember how SCOTUS said Jamie has this need for attention?
This is my file. I thought it was sealed.
I have a friend in children's services. She remembered you. She remembered how nervous her superiors were about investigating an ambassador for sexually abusing his 11-year-old daughter. It's been a very painful time for you.
Yes, it was.
How did your mother take it?
She was jealous because Daddy couldn't stand to touch her. So she sent me away to boarding school. I begged her not to, but what mother wants, mother gets.
She abandoned you, Jamie.
I survived.
Still, it must be hard facing that kind of rejection from your own daughter.
What do you mean?
Emily came out of her coma a few hours ago. She told us everything. She wants to see you. But first, you and I have a couple of details we need to straighten out.
What details?
Let's start with the hairbrush.
It's Justin's.
Yes, but we got a partial print in with Emily's testimony.
Emily's a liar.
But why would she lie?
Her father poisoned her against me. It's been very painful. Very hurtful.
Coming out of her coma. I'm not sure what we would have done if Jamie had asked to see her.
and face up to your problems, whatever they are.
Justice system, sexually based offenses are considered especially heinous. In New York City, the dedicated detectives who investigate these vicious felonies are members of an elite squad known as the Special Victims Unit. These are their stories.
Understanding. Elias wasn't the one who was shot.
Oh my God.
beautiful town.
Makes sense.
Tell them
what happened to that little boy that made you want to take?
right? You're charging a 7-year-old with murder?
Yes, Your Honor.
Surely there's an alternative.
One has yet to present itself. The commission of the crime by the respondent is undisputed, and evidence supporting criminal intent has just come to light.
How does the minor plead?
A general denial, Your Honor.
Remand recommendations?
The people have not ruled out the minor's home situation as a contributing factor. We therefore ask for the removal of the minor from his home and ask that he be remanded to a detention facility.
Your Honor, the Barreras are a loving, law-abiding nuclear family. Elias should be released into their custody.
Barreras have ties outside the country. Flight risk is a significant issue with the people and the victim's family who is here today.
I'm ordering the minor be remanded to the Wagner detention facility. I'm further ordering a clinical evaluation to determine whether or not he understands the charges against him and can help in his own defense.
No, please don't take my baby.
testimony?
Was. Know anything about it?
Santeros don't sacrifice anything for love that food chain
anyone
wants.
Long Island cheerleader 3 years ago, mother and sister thought she was possessed by a demon and they suffocated her. Santeros, right?
That was an exorcism got out of hand, not a sacrifice.
Shorty Esposito. Religious kind of guy.
Keeping the rituals a secret comes from the saints having to hide it from their masters. That's not a major.
Sure is. It's in the Constitution, freedom of religion.
It's like dogma not to talk about it. I'd be violating his rights.
Well, he's dead. He doesn't have any rights.
You're a priest.
Yeah.
Abelou.
Abelou. Atheist businessman. 300,000 people practice Santeria in New York. They need to shop someplace they can trust.
Hey, maybe someone trying to drive an evil spirit out of him with a bullet.
My bet? That was his religion.
A guy right there in the corner, that's a steer. Right the fire to the money man. Let him hanging back, gold chain. That's the money man. He never touches the dope.
You're all teased, man. They know a lie's told, old brother.
Somewhere around here.
He's the lookout.
Thank you.
both camouflaged.
This is not Carly. This is Shorty.
Meaning Elias witnessed this murder. When he drew this, he wasn't plotting out Carly Jackson's murder. This was a cry for help. He wanted somebody to know what he saw. He's been through an interrogation, a court hearing, taken from his family and placed in detention. Why wouldn't he have said something by now?
Well, look at the players involved, drug dealers and killers. If Elias was drawn into this world at all, he knows what happens to people who talk. So what are we going to do?
When an accused stands mute, the only thing the system can do is interpret his actions.
You know our take on it.
Well, I know what my bosses will be. They'll still see a bad apple who likes seeing people dead. So Elias needs to talk. His attorney won his motion. He's back home until the hearing.
Go.
You know, you people have some nerve.
It's been horrible for the Barreras. They're prisoners in their own home. The protesters, death threats, the media trying to sneak into the building.
We try to be good parents, we do.
Social services is threatening to remove their baby girl.
Mr. Barrera, it is imperative we talk to Elias.
Why? So you can find something else to charge him with?
Mrs. Barrera, we believe that your son witnessed a murder the night before the shooting.
What? Can you write Mrs. Stratus?
sponges,
trash cans, light switches. You lifted a few baseboards.
No trace of blood yet.
Pillows missing.
Okay.
Where's the curtains?
We got blood.
Wheel marks.
Yes, any hurt sirens.
It's fine with that problem.
Already out of hand. Somebody pulled out a knife. Somebody else pulls out a Louisville slugger. We're all spilled out into the courtyard.
Take any statements?
35. Stopped everyone leaving the building.
If that's when our guy left the building, he might be one of them.
Can I have to borrow these? Off Elias' description, we've eliminated 28 names based on age and gender.
Which we brought down to 8 suspects, 5 of whom have records.
And mugshots.
Already there, we put together a photo array, showed it to Elias. He recognize any of them?
Yeah, 2.
Unless I'm one of them, I don't know why you're still standing here.
Because he's positive neither of them is Machete.
So, who do we have left?
The 3 didn't have records and no photos. Quan Quan, Nikki Crew, and Bobby Cruz.
We met them all. On the south side corner.
So one of them is Machete.
Quan owns a market and was pretty helpful in getting us some IDs.
Maybe too helpful.
Crew profits off the piety of the local Centeros.
Cruz is a dope dealer.
Elias needs some points with the DA's office. Call his attorney, see if he'll let him do some walk-bys.
Thank you.
you think you're going to burn in hell for what you did?
I know why you're here. Oh, forget it. I already gave the shooting to McCoy. You should have seen his face.
Same one. I'm not here to pick up a case. I'm here to drop one.
Oh, no. We can't give that kid a free ride.
We only got Machete because of Eliza's drawing.
That doesn't bring Carly Jackson back.
Her death is a tragedy.
Yes.
But it was self-defense. The vice principal of the school corroborates his story. Machete and his gang were there.
Did she see them attack him, draw a weapon?
This is what he thinks is going to happen to him.
Well, I think that makes your case. Proves that he knows the difference between right and wrong.
No, we are the ones who don't know the difference.
I'll be right there. We're going to bend the charges to manslaughter.
I don't want to prosecute a child at all for a series of society's mistakes. The Barreras HMO wouldn't cover their baby's condition, forcing them to work two jobs. So they had to find affordable daycare for Lies, which, as we both know, is non-existent. So they put him in Mrs. Strada's illegal daycare. An 82-year-old who was looking after 15 children, whose great-grandson was using Eliza as a drug runner and giving him access to a loaded semi-automatic handgun. And don't get me started on the accessibility of handguns to minors. This boy should not be put away.
Nobody in Sing Sing had a great childhood in his cabin. He started killing at 7. It's not a bad predictor.
You are unbelievable.
Second in command, and I have Louis' full support in this. Now listen, people know what happened. They want justice. I need someone held responsible.
The death of Carly Jackson is the ultimate tragedy. There are no easy solutions. But we in the DA's office have a moral imperative to do the right thing. And I assure you that justice will be served. I am placing full authority in the worthy hands of a person who has been intimately involved with every aspect of this case from the beginning. Assistant District Attorney Alex Cabot.
Prosecuting 7-year-old Elias Barrera.
A Latino boy killed an African-American girl. Are you at all concerned that if you don't prosecute, it may ignite tensions in the neighborhood?
We know this was in no way racially motivated.
Sure, no responsible member of the press would even think to put that kind of slant on it.
He hung her out to try.
No matter what she does to Elias, it's lose-lose. Half the city's gonna hate her.
The other half will be turning backflips. I talked to the Barreras. Elias was formally expelled from school. The state sent him a tutor.
Didn't let that get out. The state of our educational system, people will be killing to get one.
Is there anything we can do for Kathy?
We've exhausted the pool of sacrificial heads for the platter. It's out of our hands. She needs to look at alternate solutions.
Liz, my career is on the line here.
And a little boy's future.
Believe me, I haven't forgotten about him. I can't believe my boss did this to me.
But they did.
Boys Club. I think I left.
What would you do?
You know, I really shouldn't discuss the particulars with you while I'm on retainer by the defense.
Hypothetically,
I wouldn't make him another throwaway kid and just warehouse him. I'd put him in supervised counseling.
That's not going to save the public's bloodlust. Someone has to be punished.
You know, I had a political future at one point.
Alex, historical figures I respect the most aren't the ones who started wars, but those who brought about peace. You have a real opportunity here.
The respondent clearly understands the difference between right and wrong. The time he pulled the trigger, he knew what he was doing. He intended to cause physical injury or death to the boys at the fence.
Yes, he absolutely knows what's going on here. He understands the role of the court. He understands the role of the judge. He knows his attorney is here to help him. He has the capacity to assist in his own defense.
Dr. Olivet, have you reviewed the state examiner's reports?
I have.
Do you concur with their findings?
They're absolutely right. He does understand the procedures of the court, and he knows his conduct was wrong. But in my assessment, the minor, he knows it was wrong.